Want to learn engineering and science? Well, you've tuned in to the right channel. Hit subscribe and press the bell icon and never miss an update from us.
Hey guys, what's up? This is your friend and tutor Manas, and in today's session, we're going to be discussing about a problem based on trusses. And the method that I'm going to adopt today is again going to be method of sections. So let's see what this problem has in store. Here we go. Determine the forces in the bars DC, DH and FH of the truss loaded and supported as shown in the figure. All right, so this is the arrangement in which at point A we have a hinge to support and at point B we have a roller support. Now when you speak of a hinge support, there are going to be two forces, okay? One horizontal HA while the other vertical VA, and at point B we have a roller support, and that's why you can clearly see that there is a normal reaction to this surface. All right, and let's say that the name is RB. All right, so initially I'm going to start off by using this very popular moment equation. Alright, so let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to be taking the moment about the hinge, that is at point A or about point A. Now guys, if you watch carefully, these two forces HA and VA are passing through this point A, hence their moments are going to be zero. Therefore we are left with only two forces in the form of P and this RB. If you watch carefully, this P produces a clockwise moment at point A, hence a negative sign. All right, name of the force is P, multiplied by the perpendicular distance. Now if you try to drop a perpendicular into the line of action of this force P, you can watch clearly the name of that perpendicular would be AH, whose value is going to be equal to 2 plus 2, that's 4. Done. What else? If you watch carefully, this RB produces an anti-clockwise moment at point A, hence a positive sign. Name of the force is again RP multiplied by, if this is the line of action of RP, then AB is going to be that perpendicular distance whose value is going to work out as 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, that's 8. Okay, so all of this stuff is going to be equal to 0. Now you just need to solve this equation, and the value of RB is going to work out as 0.5P. Okay, now moving ahead, we are going to use the second equation of equilibrium in the form of F of Y is equal to 0. If you watch carefully, in the Y direction we have got three forces VA, P and RB, out of which VA and RB, both of them are in the upward direction and hence positive VA plus RB, and this P force is headed downwards and hence negative, minus P is equal to 0. Now you just need to solve this equation. Okay, so VA is essentially going to be equal to P minus RB. Now the value of RB computed is half of P, so P minus a half of P, it's going to work out as, let me write this, VA is equal to again 0.5P. okay, so we've got one equation of equilibrium left, that's what we call summation of F of X is equal to 0, and when you use this, you've got only one force in the horizontal direction or in the X direction, you can say. So we can essentially write this as HA, and there is no other force, hence HA is going to be equal to 0. Okay, now let me write this over here, VA is equal to 0.5P, and RP has also worked out as 0.5P. Now that the reaction at supports have been calculated, we'll go ahead and we'll apply the method of sections to find the actual forces in the members DC, DH and FH. How can we do that? First of all, I need to pass a section, or rather just a line, which is going to cut these three members. Here we go. Okay, now let's have the forces approaching this section from both the directions, from the left and from the right. This is member DC, so let's say that the actual force along this member be represented by F of DC. Similarly, we've got F of DH and we've got F of FH. Okay, so what's next? Now I'll be using the three equations of equilibrium for finding the three unknown axial forces, right? And I'm going to start off by using this moment equation. Okay, so moment about a specific point has to be equated to zero. Now I'll choose this point D as the point about which I'm going to be taking the moment. Why point D? Well, there is a very genuine reason for that. Now point D lies towards the left of the section, okay, and hence forces towards the right will be considered. All right, so these are the green colored force that I'll be taking into account along with this RP. If you watch carefully, if you try to take moment about point D, this f of dh and f of dc, both of them appear as if they are passing through this point D. Hence, their moments are going to be zero. So essentially, you are left with only one unknown axial force in the name of f of fh. That's it. That's the only unknown axial force. Okay, so it's very beneficial. So if you take moment about point D, it will help you frame a moment equation with only one unknown axial force, that too in the name of f of fh. So let's go ahead and apply this. All right. So starting off with this f of fh, if you watch carefully about point D or at point D, this green colored f of fh produces a clockwise moment. Hence a negative sign, f of fh, simple, multiplied by, this is the line of action of force, and this is the perpendicular dropped, that is df, whose value is equal to 2 meters. So let me just write 2 over here. There you go. What else is there? Now, about point D, we have to deal with this P force also. Okay. Now, this force P is producing a clockwise moment. So this is the line of action of P, and this distance dd dash is the perpendicular dropped. This distance dd dash is equal to how much? Fh, whose value is equal to 2 meters. So what I can do is, this force P produces a clockwise moment and is in the hence a negative sign multiplied by this dd dash, which is equal to 2 meters. Okay, do we have any other force? Yes, we do have. We've got this rp. Okay, and if you watch carefully, this rp headed upwards produces an anti-clockwise moment at p, hence a positive sign. Name of the force is 0.5p, that's the value of rp, multiplied by, now let me try to make this line of action of rp, and if you were to drop a perpendicular from point D, it would be this one. Okay, so that's the perpendicular, and if you watch carefully, the distance between this point over here and this point is equal to this and this. That's how much? That's equal to 6. Okay, this distance is how much? 6. That's it. So essentially, we have to multiply 0.5p with 6. All of this stuff is going to be equal to 0. Okay, now you just need to solve this equation and you'll eventually get the value of f of fh is equal to 0.5 times of p. That's it. All right, so we are yet to calculate the values of axial forces in the form of f of dc and f of dh. Okay, now these two values can be calculated. It's going to be pretty easy. You just need to use the remaining two equations of equilibrium. Okay, that is f of x0 and f of y0. Now let me just write this, summation of f of x is equal to 0. So we have to work out all the forces which are acting in the x direction, and I'm going to be considering the right hand side portion of this section. Okay, if you watch carefully, this f of fh is already horizontal. So what needs to be done is, this f of dh and this f of dc, both of them seem to be slightly inclined at some angles. We need to resolve these two forces into horizontal and vertical components in order to ensure that they have a role to play in the f of x and f of y is equal to 0 equations. How can that be done? It's going to be pretty easy. Guys, if you watch carefully, let me try to make a sort of a construction line over here. Okay. Now we just need this angle over here, this angle I'm talking about. And this angle is equal to this angle, which is equal to theta. So in triangle DCD dash, we can write tan theta is equal to CD dash over DD dash. Watch carefully, CD dash is equal to 2.5 minus 2, that is 0.5, okay, over this DD dash, whose value is obviously 2. Okay, just need to solve this and theta shall approximately work out as 14 degrees. So we've got this theta. Okay, now let us get rid of this. Yeah. So f of dc is going to have a horizontal component of this sort. Its name is going to be f of dc cos 14, and its vertical component is headed downwards, f of dc sin 14. Similarly, f of dh is also going to have a horizontal component and a vertical component. Here we go. So this component is f of dh cos 45, and over here we'll have one more component, f of dh sine 45, basically. So let's work out. Watch carefully, this f of dc cos 14 headed left hand side, negative f of dc cos 14. That's it. Anything else? F of dh cos 45, again left hand side, negative minus f of dh cos 45, anything else. And this green colored force, okay, the name of this force is f of fh. Edit left hand side, again negative, all of this stuff is going to be equal to 0. Guys, you need to put the value of f of fh obtained in the step above over here, and let me reframe this equation. Okay, we can write this as f of dc cos 14 plus f of dh cos 45 is equal to negative of 0.5p, and let's say this is our equation number one. Okay, now let's try to frame the summation of all the forces in y direction is equal to zero equation. Okay, so here we go. F of dc sine 14 downwards, again negative, so minus of f of dc sine 14. Okay, what else? We've got this force also headed upwards, f of dh sine 45. Okay, it's going to be a positive, f of dh sine 45. Anything else? We've got this p force also headed downwards and hence negative, and we've got this rb is equal to 0.5 headed upwards and hence again positive, 0.5p is equal to 0. Let me reframe this equation, and we can write this as f of dc sine 14 minus f of dh sine 45, and I can write this as this is going to be negative of 0.5p. So we've got two equations and we've got two unknowns in the form of f of dc and f of dh. Just try to add these two equations. What happens? F of dc cos 14 and f of dc sine 14. So essentially f of dc can be taken as common. You can write this cos 14 plus sine 14. What else? Cos 45 and sine 45, both of them are same. Their values are 1 by root 2. Okay, so f of dh into 1 by root 2, and this is f of dh into 1 by root 2 again. One is positive while the other is negative. Okay, and hence they'll cancel out. The only stuff remaining is going to be towards the right hand side portion. Minus half p becomes negative of p. Alright, and from here you can get the value of f of dc, which will be equal to, let me see, negative of 0.825p. Well, negative sign is basically an indication that this member dc, where is it? DC member is simply under compression. Okay. And when you try to put the value of f of dc either in equation 1 or in equation 2, you'll eventually get the value of f of dh is equal to 0.424p. Well, that's it. It's positive, and hence it's indicating that this member dh, this dh member, is simply under tension. All right. Now, let me go ahead and highlight all this stuff. So guys, that was all from my side for today. If you've got any doubt or query, do write them down in the comment section below. I'll be very happy to answer them. And if you believe that this video tutorial has added value to your knowledge of mechanics, then do share and like this video and subscribe to this channel, and also recommend this channel to your friends and classmates so that all of them can benefit. I'll be back again with some more videos on mechanics. Until then, it's a wrap. This is Manas Patnaik signing off. Take care, have a great day, and keep learning.